1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Well, just like the tool wall has grown, so has the stickers, which I've got on the cabinet, the sticker cabinet. Got some new ones. Jack Shed sticker from UK, courtesy of a Tool Addict, who sent that sticker over for me. Joe Shop, T-Rex. You can see all the different ones I got now. MacDad, Resto Rob, Armando, which is a sticker I made because he didn't have one. Tom Gunn stickers. So, got getting together a nice little collection of them now. Anybody would like to trade stickers, I'll put my email address down there, send me your address, and I'll send you a sticker. Thanks. Here's an interesting trail I came across. Looks like it was put out in the 1950s era. A Fury made by Ram Tool Corporation, 3/8 inch drill. Doesn't say the RPM on here, just says 3/8 inch drill. It's non-reversal versing. It notice it does have a trigger lock on it, which is unusual for a drill at this time. Stained, dirty, scratched. Chuck pretty corroded. Seems to be pretty jam tight. That does have a chuck key taped or somehow taped to the cord here. So we'll get it apart, get it operational, see why it's jammed up, and clean it up because it just got an, it has an interesting look to it. Just would like to get it restored. I have another old Black & Decker from that same area that I'll show you when I get this cleaned up. We'll see how they compared. And here's that Ram Tool Corporation's Fury drill. As I got it, it was in pretty rough shape, locked up, looking pretty bad. So we did some work on it. And here's what we did. Now there's a huge transformation. Quite a change. First I took it apart, put it back together, and tried to get it running. It was running. It got it running. I actually got some brushes that I got out of another old tool I had. It was close to the size. I filed them down, sanded them down, and made them fit the tool. And of course, getting it back together was a chore. Everything was just, I don't know what it was about it. And then when I got it together, I tried to run it, and it was running pretty rough. Just sputtering, running slow. And I remembered an old trick I learned many years ago. When I started working for Black & Decker in 1968, part of my training, I was going to be in sales for them, but part of my training was to spend some time in the service center watching them and helping them repair tools to learn all about the tools from the inside out. I thought it was a waste of time, but I did pick up some valued information. And while I was trying to get this to run, by golly, I remembered something because it just was running terrible. And I remembered the technician who was working on the tools picked up the tool, got a hammer, and started tapping all over the tool, and it started sounding better and better and better and better. And I said, what did you just do? I mean, it's like I would do to fix something, hitting it with a hammer. He said, when you start it up after you've had it apart, this is true on the older tools, I don't know if it is today, everything is just not seated right. the brush is just not quite seated right. Maybe a bearing just it didn't ride exactly in place. He said, give it some taps. Well, I gave it some taps, and here's what I got out of it. Let me plug it in here. Oh, that was a spark. Did you see that? You can see the blue flame in there. And that spark came out of that. I guess there was a little chip of a brush in there. They're just seeding and mating with the armature. So that's why the big spark. I guess you can see the blue flame. So it's working just great. Not going to drill a hole with it. We know it'll drill a hole. It's running great. There's plenty of strength in that. It's got a nice Jacob chuck on it. Took it and sanded it all the way down. Started with 120 grit, got all the way up to 600 grit. And then I put it on the wire wheel brush, and then I put it on the fiber wheel and got it going pretty good. Finally finished it off with Flitz, and that Flitz just brought out a little extra in it, like it always does. Flitz is a great item. I don't know what attracted me up, by the way. The label just turned out great on it. Fury 3/8 inch drill, 2.6 amps. It doesn't say it, but I looked it up. It's 1,000 RPM. And also was model number F4. And I found an old ad for it back from 1967. Now, this drill was made earlier in the 50s. But I found an ad from 1967, and this drill sold retail for $8.69. But, of course, they don't make them that way anymore with the metal housing. They're all plastic and rubber. And it's changed, but it's an old classic. It kind of reminded me of an Airstream trailer. I don't know why, the curvature or whatever. That's what it reminded me of. Also got another one in my collection I want to bring up for comparison. And that is a Black & Decker drill, which I featured in, I think, my first or second video, I believe, when I was showing my tool collection. And this tool was in really rough shape. It actually, I had it for many years. I bought it at a estate sale for $5, maybe 30 years ago, 40 years ago. This drill was made in the late 1940s. And had some nice features like keyless chuck, believe it or not, back at that time. That's what the keyless chuck looked like. And this tool works and runs fine. But in 2010, we had a giant flood in Nashville. And my business was underwater. We got about four to 5 feet of water in the building. I think 4 feet of water in the building. Everything that level down was just completely covered with water and silt and mud and muck from the flood. And this tool, unfortunately, was in there too. I had the original box, all the original papers. It was quite a nice item to have, and really a keepsake from my career, which I started with Black & Decker. So I made it a mission a year or so ago to take this tool apart, and I got it apart, got it cleaned, got it running, and then shined it up and buffed it up like I did the other one. And it's a nice companion piece. This was made in the late 40s. This was made in the 50s. And the parts in here are a lot different. A lot of ball bearings in here. This tool has got one thrust bearing that I can find, and the rest are all what I call sleeve bearings, which are just a piece of a metal sleeve. So it's not going to be long lasting and hold up to heavy industrial use. And this one was actually sold as an industrial model under one number, and this was a home HU, which is home utility drill. And but a couple of nice items to have, and thanks for taking time to look it over today.